Back for more, eh? Consider subscribing. The tutorials and plugin took a long time to prepare, and you can always unsubscribe if you change your mind. Now, we can assign a variable to a boolean, but let's do more. This operator compares two values and gives us a boolean that represents whether they're equal. If we assign the result of this to our variable is now set to true. This is because 5 and 5 are equal. As 2 and 6 are not equal, the condition now returns false. Remember, the assignment operator is for setting, and this comparison operator is used for getting. We can also compare any data types to each other like these. Additionally, we can also use variables and perform other operations before the values are compared. There are also a range of other operators that we can use. This operator returns true if the value on the left is less than the value on the right, and this one checks if the left value is less than or equal to the right value. This operator returns true if the left value is greater than the value on the right, and this one checks if the left value is greater than or equal to the right value. And finally, this operator returns true if the values are not equal. We can also compare multiple conditions at once with AND and OR. These examples return true because the first and second conditions are both true. These return false because the first and second conditions aren't both true. Next, these examples return true because at least one of the conditions is true. However, these examples return false because neither the first or second condition is true. Just like with maths, we can use order of operations with brackets. This example returns true because while the condition in brackets returns false, 3 is still equal to 3. And finally, we can use the NOT keyword to inverse a boolean, as shown here. This might take some practice to get used to, so make sure you've installed the exercise plugin linked in the description. Now, what if you want to run something if our boolean is true? This is where if statements come in. An if statement looks like this, and checks whether a value is truthy, meaning it isn't false or nil. Blocks of code like this always end with the end keyword, which represents the end of a block of code. We can give the if statement any of the conditions we created earlier, and if it is truthy, it will run the code inside the block. Otherwise, the block of code will be ignored and the computer will skip past it. Now, you might notice that we use tabs or spaces to represent the block of code. While tabs and spaces are ignored, and you can technically just put an entire script on one line, the white space makes it easier for someone to read our script. If we were to embed multiple if statements like this, it's a lot clearer which blocks of code are located where. Each of these blocks has its own scope, which allows you to declare local variables that don't interfere with the rest of the script. For example, with the local keyword, variable b can only be accessed within the if statement scope, whereas the scope outside the if statement has never seen the variable. However, variable a doesn't use the local keyword, so is declared as a global variable which can be accessed in all scopes. If we declare a local variable outside of our if statement, we can still access it inside the if statement. This is because the if statement scope can access all of the scopes it is inside of. When referring to a variable, the computer will go through each scope and find the variable in the closest scope. For example, this script outputs 10 and then outputs 5. The same goes for reassigning variables as well. Note that it's good practice to use local variables where possible. A script like this would be considered much better practice, as variables in closer scopes are slightly faster for the computer to access. Make sure to experiment with this if you're unsure about anything. Now, if the first condition of an if statement isn't met, we might want to run another block of code instead. For this, we can use elsif, which is an extension to our if statement and looks like this. If the if statement's condition isn't met, the computer will then check the elsif segment beneath. It will check through each next segment until one of the conditions is met. For example, this script outputs 7 because that block of code has the first condition that is truthy. Elsif segments underneath now get skipped because an if statement only checks for the first match. Finally, if we want to run a block of code if no segments of the if statement run, we can use else, which looks like this. In this example, only the code within the else block runs because all the conditions above it gave back a falsy value. This works with an unlimited amount of elsif segments as well as just a single if statement. And congratulations, you now understand conditions and scopes. Be sure to practice with the plugin and then move on to loops when you're ready.